Talk UK, it's Frankie B. Repping the Pep Talk boys. Remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe to Pep Talk UK. And I'm joined by today at Punch London, the light heavyweight that is Frank Buglioni. I got it right once.
Yeah, very good. Another Frankie B.
So how's things been?
Yeah, very well, thank you, mate. Been training hard. A lot of people saying, oh, this is your comeback and this, that, and the other. Mm-hmm. I don't see it as that because, yeah, I've been beat, but that's part of the game. I've been there before. I was beat by a solid opposition, an unbeaten fighter. Second unbeaten fighter to beat me. He's a genuine world-class fighter, Callum Johnson.
Callum Johnson, yeah.
Good amateur pedigree and very powerful. And he started fast and he went for it early and he got his tactics right. So, yeah, I mean, I can't be too disappointed. Listen, he caught me with a shot. I didn't recover in time.
Which can happen to any fighter.
Of course. So I can't, and it was, I can't make excuses because it was the best I'd trained. Mm-hmm. Done everything correct.
You're always in shape. You're never slacking off.
Yep. Yeah, I made the weight absolutely perfect. I was hitting PBs in the gym, on my runs, in the weights room. Everything was great. And probably a little bit too prepared. I felt so good, so confident in my chin, so confident in my fitness and my strength and my power. Maybe I was a little bit careless. Maybe I did think I was indestructible. So it's done me a favour.
Do you feel like there was a slight bit of overconfidence going into the fight and on fight night itself in terms of Callum Johnson?
Do you know what? I knew he was going to be a decent opposition. I knew him from the amateurs. I'd seen him fight. I also knew he was vulnerable. I caught him early. And if you re-watch the fight, for a jab to the head, jab to the body.
Yeah.
Caught him with a good right hand over the top. I see him momentarily dazed, and my eyes lit up before I caught him. And now I've just got to put the pressure on. I walked in and caught one myself, and his shot done a lot more damage than what mine did. And he recovered from the shot that I caught him with, and I didn't recover from the shot he caught me with. So it's one of those things. But having said that, I've put even more into my game. And even more in my training camp this time. And I intend to improve and progress from it.
Because I was slightly surprised, because usually I see you as someone, you know, you're quite patient in the ring.
Yeah.
And this time you're just looking to go out and blast out Callum Johnson. Do you know what? It is sometimes a case
of the unbeaten thing, the record and winning the British outright.
And there's nothing really like a buzz, like a stoppage or a knockout. That buzz is fantastic.
It's been a lifelong goal of mine. I've always chased that, and to make history of beating all undefeated fighters. Mm-hmm. I felt that the timing was right, and I was in tip-top shape, and it wasn't to be. But there's plenty of upsets in life, and you got to come through them. That's what it's all about.
Shit happens, as they say.
Of course.
So what about being on sort of on the combat trail? Has there been any like mental demons that you've had to overcome before getting back into training?
Really, I mean, obviously, I've taken the positives from that. I've taken the fact that, I mean, the Kamitsky loss, I got the weight wrong, my camp was up in the air for that fight, and I wasn't really myself. Then obviously, shooting off Burton, been in with some decent punches.
Great fight, the Burton fight.
Not really, like, obviously I've felt shots, but I've never really been rocked. So that was the first time that I've really well and truly been rocked and felt like my legs go. So it's let me know that everyone can be hurt. And it's shown me another way, and shown that in my sparring and my training. I've kind of boxed and moved and been a little bit more patient and set traps and used my boxing ability. So I've been boxing for 15, 16 years now. So I can box and I can move and I can evade shots. It's just that I've always done it the other way because I thought I don't want to leave it to the judges. I want to get the stoppage. I want to be entertaining. Whereas now I've kind of gone win at all costs, still be entertaining and exciting, and still punch hard, but don't take unnecessary risks. And yes, it's been a hard lesson, but you got to learn from it.
And to be fair, you fighting against a man who lost his father in the build up. And you had that added motivation to really, you know, bring home the title.
Yeah, I said it before and I'll say it again. If I was going to lose my British title and to lose it to someone, then Callum Johnson, what he's been through and what he's come and he's shown his courage and his heart and his desire. And I truly believe, I watched, kind of slightly off topic, I watched one of Turbiev's fights when he got dropped.
Okay.
So he can be hurt. And Callum Johnson can really whack. So I know that they've taken that fight. They've obviously seen the fight where Turbiev was dropped and hurt. I thought, you know what? If Johnson hits him like that,
mm-hmm.
and this was right at the end of the round as well. He didn't know where he was when he got up and the bell had gone. So if he catches him in a mid round or early, Johnson's got the potential to stop Turbiev and become a world champion. And I really hope he does it. I'd love the rematch if he did win the world title. Of course, he's not going to fight Burton. Yard don't want to fight anyone, so that's a fight off. So really, in terms of if he wants to bring it back domestically,
mm-hmm.
then I'm there waiting for him.
And to be fair, you know, I think a lot of people would be interested in that because it was a good scrap before it ended, you and Johnson. Now, moving forward...
Yeah, I think people know that they know I'm not going to make the same mistake twice, and maybe it'll certainly be a lot more entertaining, closer fight next time.
Sounds like it'd be real saucy.
Yep.
So moving forward, now, like I said, you know, you're a very determined individual. You won't be held back. You've been back in training for the Dillian White versus Joseph Parker card. How has it been being back in the gym?
Yeah, it's been great. I mean, I took about 4 weeks off because I tore the ligaments in my knee.
Oh wow!
A little bit sooner.
Okay.
When I went down the foot, like in the fight, I tore the ligaments in my knee. So I was on unsteady legs when I got up, which wasn't aware of, but yeah, so when my leg went, obviously my knee had gone, so there wasn't much I could have done anyway, but yeah, so I waited for that to heal, got back in the gym, and yeah, I've been flying since.
Okay. Well, what do you listen to when you train? I know that's a bit off the chain.
Music?
Yeah, music. What do you listen to?
All different.
Bit of Stormzy?
Yeah, I like that. What do we have on this morning? I'll tell you what we had on this morning. And I'm a bit embarrassed to admit it, but it was the Love Island Ministry of Sound playlist.
Oh, Frank.
It was all the house classics. It was quite good, actually.
Oh, yeah? It was good,
yeah? Decent, yeah.
It got you hitting the pads a bit harder.
Yeah. 14 rounds down.
So, July the 28th, O2 Arena, under the bright lights again. Do you know much about an opponent?
Yeah, I mean, there's been talk of guys, but it's not going to be a pushover. It's going to be a guy with a winning record. Be someone tough and durable. Like I say, a winning record, just coming there to obviously seeing the fact that I'm coming off a first round KO loss, and they'll be looking to try and exploit that, and we're going to make sure that don't happen.
Excellent. So what about the World Cup before we conclude? England have gone out, unfortunately. Italy didn't make it for you.
Yep.
Ghana didn't make it for me. Disappointment all round, isn't it?
Yeah, obviously I've got Italian heritage, but I'm English first and foremost, and I support the English football team, number one priority. They're first, second and third. And then if England got knocked out, then obviously I'd be following Italy if they were still in it. But yeah, I mean, I'm English. My family, we consider ourselves English, and we follow the England team.
Yeah. I really thought it was coming home, but we came home instead, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But hats off to Croatia, they played a good game. They recovered from an early goal. And,
the hard thing with that is because we definitely had the potential to beat
them. Right, yeah, yeah.
And we had the potential, we could have been 3-0 up at half time and put the game to bed. So that's the frustrating thing. But that being said, if someone said, you're going to get to the semis of the World Cup final and have a close game at the start before it all kicked off, I would have gone, yeah, I'll take that. But then when it happens, you think, no, we could have done better. There was potential there. But, It was a great ride. I think the boys done themselves proud. I think Dele Alli and Kane were probably carrying injuries towards the end of the
yeah,
cup.
Yeah, Kane was knackered in the Croatia game.
Yeah, I think they've had long, hard seasons, and the better they are, the more games they play and the more cups they've been in. So it's a tough ask.
The life of a footballer, all hard work, eh?
Listen, they get compensated well for it, but
yeah.
when you're playing at the elite in any sport, whatever the sport is, when you're playing at the very elite, there's a lot of pressure and there's a lot of things that come with it. I mean, looking from the outside, on the outside looking in, you think, oh, it's easy, they're getting paid big money, they're getting this, they're getting that, but it's when you're there and you're amongst it, the most important thing is winning and doing well. So there's massive pressure, and obviously the money's good and it gives you security, but there's plenty of more things in life that are important.
Right, now what about your team Chelsea? You've just sacked your manager again.
First I've heard of that, right. So yeah, my brother will be updating me on that. He follows everything Chelsea, so he'll give me the lowdown. Yeah.
But in fairness, it's worked for you. You know, you sack managers and you win stuff, so that's the winning formula, right?
Yeah, they're doing something, right? It's whether Eden Hazard, I mean, there's rumours of him.
Real.
Yeah, Madrid. Yeah, so hopefully we don't. I mean, yeah, we'll see. We'll see what happens.
We'll see. You'll be an Arsenal fan just like me one day.
No, I don't know about that.
Right, Frank Buglioni, we'd like to wish you all the best of luck.
Cheers,
and July the 28th, remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe to Pep Talk UK. Shout out my chi, Frank Buglioni.
Top man.
Thank you.
Cheers, mate.